Our Care 11 Sports All-Metro offensive team is led by St. Paul Johnson's Thomas Tepay. The senior running back was absolutely fabulous. Tepay rushed for 1,845 yards and 27 touchdowns in just 10 games. At 6'2", 220, Tepay has deceptive speed. There's no doubt Tepay is the state's most highly sought-after football recruit. Woodbury's Louis Ianni is having an outstanding senior season. The tailback at 6'1", 190 has tremendous speed. He's rushed for 1,712 yards, a 7.4-yard average, and 31 touchdowns, which includes a school record 5 in one game, all in the first half. Woodbury is 11-1 and plays Eden Prairie in the state semifinals. Running back Kaven Shear of Champlin Park makes big plays. Watch Shear, number 20. He scored 8 game-winning touchdowns in 11 games for the Rebels. He's rushed for over 1,180 yards, scoring 16 touchdowns on the ground. Shear also has 379 yards receiving with 8 touchdown receptions. When Champlin Park needs a big play, Kaven Shear is the guy. The Rebels are 10-1. Hutchinson's Chris Davis broke all sorts of school career rushing and touchdown records this fall. Watch Davis, number 32. At 6'1", 205, he has good speed and is tough to bring down. Davis has rushed for 1,451 yards this season and over 3,700 yards in his career. Davis scored 23 touchdowns this fall, which gives the senior a record 55 overall. Hutchinson is undefeated and in the state semifinals. Our All-Metro quarterback is Champlin Park's John Stock. All he does is win. Stock has thrown for 1,476 yards and 17 touchdowns and rushed for another 420 and 3 TDs. Stock's completed 62% of his passes with only 3 interceptions. Stock calls 50% of the plays to the line of scrimmage, which shows his intelligence. Champlin Park plays Creighton Durham Hall in the state semifinals. Our All-Metro wide receivers are led by De La Salle's Ben Johnson. Watch Johnson, number 1, come across the middle and then break the play open for a touchdown. Ben, at 6'4", 185, made 51 catches for 831 yards and 10 touchdowns. He's going to Northwestern on a basketball scholarship. Maple Grove's Jeff Hess, at 6'6", 205, had a big season. He was quite a target, making 48 catches for 719 yards and 11 touchdowns. He also scored on 9 two-point conversions. Hess has over 1,600 yards receiving in a brilliant 3-year career. Our All-Metro tight end is Buffalo's number 85, Brent Swigert. Swigert, at 6'5", 260, is known for his excellent blocking ability, like this one against Cambridge. Swigert is a big-time Division I recruit. He also made 8 catches for 220 yards and 3 touchdowns. Buffalo finished 10-1 on the season. Our All-Metro offensive line is led by an emotional Connor Crimmins of Moundsview. Watch Crimmins, at 6'3", 270, make the key block on this play to spring the quarterback loose for a long run. Crimmins was a 3-year starter, playing both ways and a big reason for the Mustangs' recent success. White Bear Lake coach Bob Jackson says Tim Moore is one of the best beer guards he's ever coached. Watch Moore, number 78. He pancakes the defensive tackle on this play. Moore is a great technician. At 6'2", 275, the senior rarely blew an assignment. White Bear Lake rushed for over 3,000 yards this season. Champlin Park's Tom Higbee is only a junior at 6'4", 270. Higbee improved as the season wore on. Champlin Park coach Tim Herman says Higbee is a rare combination of size and aggressiveness. When the Rebels needed yards, they ran behind Higbee. Prior Lake's Matt Brown, number 78, is 6'1", 320. Watch Brown with a big block as he blows out the linebacker on this play. He has quick feet for a 320-pounder. Watch Brown bury the defensive tackle on this play to open the hole, and the running back scores the touchdown. Prior Lake finished the season 7-3. Our All-Metro kicker is Cooper High's Dan Nystrom. Nystrom made 8 of 12 field goals, including 2 from 50 and 52 yards in one game. He's the first Minnesota Prep kicker to ever do that. He's going to the Gophers on scholarship. And our coach of the year is Maple Grove's Craig Hansen. Hansen led the Crimson to their first ever conference championship. The Crimson advanced to the state quarterfinals and finished 9-2. That's quite a turnaround for Maple Grove after winning only two games prior to this fall.